department. Before I introduce our speaker, I would like to
cover a few housekeeping topics. Today's webinar is being recorded. We will be able to share a link with you after the event is complete. We welcome you to revisit the content yourself and share it with your colleagues. We also invite your comments and questions. Please look at the Q&A chat box on your screen. If you think of a question for the speaker at any point, just type it in there and I will either pose it to our speaker at that time or hold it for the discussion portion at the end of the event. Today's presenter is Mr. Manish Pandey, our alumni of 2006 batch, the first batch of IMSCC. He started with Progressive Infotech in 2006 as consultant, joined Wipro as senior system engineer in 2007, joined HCL in 2008, played multiple roles in multiple countries, and reached to the group technical manager level, moved to Oracle USA in 2017 as principal development operator and data science engineer, joined AWS as cloud technical account manager in 2019. In 2019, completed certificate in data science from Georgetown University, USA. Currently working with Amazon. Again, thank you all for joining. Now I request Manish sir to carry on.
Thank you. Thank you all. Little correction on one part. Smriti, it's DevOps, principal DevOps engineer, not data operator. So just little correction on that. So we'll start. What do you guys prefer? We should speak in English, we speak in Hindi. I can either way. What do you suggest, Atul sir?
Mixed.
तो आप लोग कैसे हैं? थैंक यू आपने ज्वाइन किया संडे को. छुट्टी है सबकी, मेरी भी ऑलमोस्ट 12 बज रहे हैं, बट मेरी बात हुई अतुल सर से और इट्स लाइक अ ग्रेट मोमेंट टू टॉक यू गाइस एंड थैंक्स फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन लार्ज नंबर. बिफोर जंपिंग टू द टॉपिक आई जस्ट टुक अ लिटिल आई विल टेक अ लिटिल मोमेंट थोड़ा टाइम आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन माय जर्नी विद IMS. So as Smriti told, I was the part of 2002 batch. So हमारा पहला batch था. कोई senior नहीं थे, उसके काफी advantages थे. मैं अपनी बात करूँ तो मैंने computer science branch में join किया था. पढ़ाई कम ही करी शुरुआत में, जब तक third year तक नहीं आ गया तब तक पढ़ाई कम ही करी. I was very graceful. Like हमारे पास जो टीचर्स थे काफी अच्छे टीचर्स थे, अतुल सर थे, अनु खान सर थे, हमारे प्रिंसिपल वीके जैन थे, सुभाष कृष्णन चितले थे, तो दे आर लाइक ग्रेट टीचर्स. उनको काफी एक्सपर्टीज थी अपनी फील्ड में, हम लोग को काफी समझाते थे, मोटिवेट करते थे. तो काफी अच्छी जर्नी रही. एक चीज जो मैंने रियलाइज करी, बिल्कुल कोई शॉर्टकट नहीं है लाइफ पे, आपको कभी ना कभी मेहनत करनी पड़ेगी. इंजीनियरिंग में करनी पड़ेगी, इंजीनियरिंग में नहीं करी तो जॉब में ज्यादा करनी पड़ेगी. मेरी आवाज साफ आ रही है? आई एम ऑडिबल? ओके,
यस,
क्लियर.
ओके ओके, थैंक यू. तो जब मैं फोर्थ ईयर में था, काफी सारे कैंपस में बैठे हैं और काफी जगह नहीं हुआ, तो कई बार लोग डीमोटिवेटेड हो जाते हैं. मैंने तो डिसाइड कर लिया था कि आई विल गो फॉर टीचिंग, बट अनु खान सर तो सामने बोला कि लास्ट थिंग यू शुड ट्राई मैन, ऑफ कैंपस ट्राई करो. तो मैंने काफी जगह ट्राई किया. लकली बिफोर आई क्लियर माय फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन मेरा प्रोग्रेसिव इंफोटेक में हो गया. अच्छी, काफी अच्छी छोटी कंपनी थी, स्टार्टअप थी, काफी अच्छा रहा उधर. फिर विप्रो एक साल काम किया उधर. फिर तो जब एक उस एक साल में मैंने अपने लाइफ में सबसे ज्यादा मेहनत करी होगी पढ़ाई या फिर किसी चीज को सीखने के लिए. फिर उसका मेरा विप्रो में हो गया, मैं 6 महीने US चला गया. देन इट्स लाइक देन आई कम टू नो कि किधर काम करना है, कितना काम करना है, फोकस कहाँ रखना है. जो कि बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. मतलब वट एवर यू प्रैक्टिस यू बिकम लाइक दैट. सो इफ यू प्रैक्टिस डिस्ट्रैक्शन यू बिकम डिस्ट्रैक्टेड. इफ यू प्रैक्टिस कंसंट्रेशन यू बिकम कंसंट्रेटेड. सो जो भी आप प्रैक्टिस करोगे, अगर आप जॉय प्रैक्टिस करोगे डे टू डे, यू बिकम अ जॉयफुल. तो ऐसा रहा. तो अभी ज्यादा अभी टाइम इस पर नहीं लगाएंगे अभी. विल जंप टू द टॉपिक. मुझे प्रेजेंटर राइट कैसे मिलेंगे इसमें?
Okay, I need to admit. Just one is we can see what if data sets.
Okay. Thank you. Sorry guys, like I think you may be a presenter, then only you can get that presenter, right? So how many of you like heard data science before? Or they know a little bit about data science? Anybody?
Yes sir, I know something about it.
Okay. And how many of you today here for learning something new? I hope everybody.
What?
Okay. We throw a session, we'll do the session interactive, and you should ask me a question. Lot of questions, whatever you have, I will recommend you ask me this question. Whenever you think, right, I think Smriti already told you, like, you can finger and she will stop me. But I want this session to be interactive as much as possible, so we can take a lot of things from there. So yeah, what I did, right, it's like some of you already know the little bit data science, somebody are very new to that, somebody won't heard at all. So this session I created certain slides based upon covering all type of audience, and the objective for this is not teaching data science in 1 hour. The objective is you should start from here. You should start questioning from to yourself how you want to learn the data science. I put lot of resources there, so I will share the slide to Atul sir, and they will distribute that too. Yeah. So anybody can explain me what as per you, what is your view on data science? What do you think, right? I think Divyam told that he know little bit about data science. What do you know, Divyam? Or what is your perspective on data science?
Sir, mainly I think that data science means data delivery with decision making.
Okay. And what is the data
analysis?
What is the data? Yeah. Okay. Go ahead. So we all know what is the data, and we all know what is the science. And what you told Divyam is like you are not wrong. It's like one part of that, one part of data science. But it's simply a science behind data. And as you correctly said, we can do the data analysis. So we talk about any science, like as we talk about the science. What do? You write some hypothesis. You do experiments. You collect the results and you validate the result. So same thing apply to the data science. And it is not like, it is not very new term, it's like from ages. People are talking about data analysis, people are doing data analysis. If you heard, there is a company called SAS, it's like leading in data science, SAS. In yes, 50s, they founded in North Carolina University, USA in 50s. So like it's quite long time where we are living with data science. But it's like become more popular these days because our machines got a lot of compute. When I say the compute means more CPU, memory, hardware, and it's cheap. The storage become cheap, network become cheap. Now the cloud come into the picture, so people got a lot of horsepower on their machine to run. So that's why we're running a lot of stuff for experiment become easy on data science. I'm hearing some background noise, so if you guys can mute yourself, that will be great. thank you. So as I told, like the old method, it's not very new. So we start with 62, like people are doing they're talking about, there's a Mr. John W. Techie, and he's talking about the data analysis. अमित सबको हम म्यूट कर सकते हैं क्या? स्मृति हम सबको म्यूट कर सकते हैं क्या एक बार?
Yes sir, sure, sure.
Thank you. So in 1960, so as I told, it's like not very new concept. It's pretty old. In 62, people start talking about that future of data analytics. In 74, there is a survey, like people start doing the surveys in computer. Where they start collecting the data, they start talking about that, how we can refine the data, manipulate the data. In 77, like there is a books written about the exploration of data analytics. Database come in 90s, Oracle comes with that big database, and it's become very famous, so that's become easy to store the data. The term data science deeply in 1996, when people start talking about data science and data scientist. And there is a difference. Sometimes many folks misunderstood data science, machine learning. There's a very broad line between the data science, machine learning, cognitive learning, and data products. So oftenly people got confused between data science and data analytics and data products, like where they only do the statistical analysis. Is there any question? Okay, so I will suggest the books in the end. So I have not one book, there are a lot of books. I will go through that point. It is part of my slides. I hope I am able to answer your question, Divyam. Okay. So 97 terms where you start becoming popular in US and many other places, that is data science. Okay. So there is a Conway Venn diagram that talk about different roles or different, you can say, skill set or domains. Where people, many folks will misunderstood between data science, data product, data engineers. So what is that red graph, red circle? Hacking skills. Hacking doesn't mean like you are doing the cyber hacking stuff. When we talk about programming languages, we have different level. We start with beginner. We have beginner is like, it's just writing a small code. A little bit here and there is writing the code. Then second step is called hacker. Hacker means you start understanding the language, but you are not using a lot of functions. You're not using very structured way of programming. You typically use that program. It's not rewritable program, but you know how to write a program, how to make the stuff done, and that's be called hacker. So that's hacker skill. And very another important skills that in field of data science is mathematics and your knowledge of statistics. And we go through in upcoming slides why it is important. And third is subject make your subject expertise on subject matter. So for example, somebody knows cybersecurity, somebody knows mechanical, supply chain, heavy electrical, finance, those are the skill set we call like your specialized skill set. And we all need, either in single person or we need in a team that forms your data science group. So if you combine your math skills and with hacking skills, you know, it's like the guy doing the machine learning techniques, he's expert on machine learning. The data science typically cutting edge of all three, like you know a little bit all three. And if you only know stats and your core subject, you become maybe a researcher, your traditional research on stats or exploring the data. any questions? And stop me if something is going on. I'm taking like a jargon, or you don't understand that term. Please ask me. So there is a guy called DJ Patil, and he is like talk about little bit more about data science. So he say like in 2008 he was working with his colleague Jeff, and they was writing certain data structure for Facebook and LinkedIn, and they say first time where we people start using data science as a professional specialization. Before that, there was a skill set is available. SaaS is already there in the market, but typically people, the field is called data analytics field, but they are not talking about the data scientist. So in 2008, it start picking up, and when we was doing our engineering, it's like very little. Somebody sometimes say, okay, something called data science. We don't know that data science was there. Once I start working in some of the project in early 2010, then I come to know something is there in the default data science. And how that grow like, so then they realize how that is differentiate between the business analytics and data analytics work. And they focus on certain aspect of the business. So that actually define a data scientist. Where you, and there is a different phases of that, which I will cover in upcoming slides. So here is a noun, like, so data scientist, what is that? This is a noun. The person who better statistics and programming, it can be a data scientist. Okay. Or a statistician, we know better programming, he can be a data scientist. So becoming a data scientist, and there is a different, when you go to the field of data science, you can, based upon your skill set, there is a multiple fields, something called data engineer, which actually handles the data, and we will go with the data science. When I go explain the data science pipeline, I will go each field where then somebody can opt, or based upon his interest, you can go on that. So something we call data scientist, some people can be a data engineer. You can be a data operations, you can be a coder, or if you know mathematics, you can be a algorithm designer. So there is a lot of aspect to that, and you can choose one of another and make expertise on that, and then you can move on to the next field if you want. So who are the data scientists? And so sometimes, as I told initially, right, so there's a difference in the data science scientists versus the people are working on data products. So data products is the products that based on the combination of data and algorithms. So when I say the data products, for example, you are doing your business intelligence where you are collecting the data and then you are applying certain algorithm, and it's a data product, not actually a data science product, because it's required some more things or substance to be added to become a product as a data science product. So for example, sometimes some banks claim like their online banking is it's not data science product. You're doing blogging, and in blogs you are making tax on the blog, that's not data science. Like for example, they are saying, okay, every month you are buying so much, these many things, and next month you can buy it. It's a predictive analysis, it's not data science. Any questions? Prasmiti, I'm going okay, or I'm going so fast, or?
It's all right, sir. You're going good.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Cool. Yeah. Another, sir, just leave it. That's not. So anybody can tell me, right, all of these three recommendations, searches, optimization, what you think? Is this a data science product? And like you're getting the movie recommendation in Netflix, or you are getting the optimized search for your travel site. Do you think it's a data science product, and why you think so? Anybody can answer that question? No.
Yes, sir. It's a database. It's a data science product. Just because we can thought that like recommendations are usually come while somebody or the data has been analyzed by our system. So it analyzes our data again and again, and it came to a recommendation like, this person is liking this thing or this person want to see this kind of content.
Right, right. You are correct. Right. So I can argue on that, Rahul, saying that okay, I can write a simple algorithm. I say, okay, Rahul watching always action movie, and I create a tag and I do the summarization of saying that always action movies you are always watching more often, then you will like more action movies, right? So that's like a, it's a simple you can say sum of your features, one feature. So why you think it's a data science product Netflix? You are right, it's a data science, but can you give me answer what I ask? I can just tag your I can just analyze your one type of tag, what type of movies you are watching more, and I just do the sum of that and say okay, it's action movies your favorite.
Sir, surely, but the thing is ki data science mein basically recommendations hi hum log maximum आते हैं, और जो चीज़ें सामने आती है सर लाइक कि उसने हमारी डाटा को काफ़ी टाइम पर रीएवेल्यूएट किया है, जिस वजह से हमें रिकमेंडेशन आ रही है, एंड रेदर देन इसके आगे
यू आर राइट. सो तो रिकमेंडेशन आना एक आउटपुट है डेटा साइंस का, वो रिकमेंडेशन डेटा प्रोडक्ट से भी आ सकती है. तो डिफरेंस क्या है, जैसे राहुल ने बोला कि उसमें फीडबैक है. अच्छा, फीडबैक जो आएगा वो कोई ह्यूमन एनालाइज नहीं करेगा, उसको आपका प्रोग्राम एनालाइज करेगा, और दैट प्रोग्राम शुड एफिशिएंट टू हैंडल द न्यू फीडबैक जो कि एज अ रिजल्ट हमारे पास आया है, एंड इट विल एनालाइज एंड इट गिव द मोर एक्यूरेट द प्रेडिक्शन. फॉर एग्जांपल, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ, ओके, यू जस्ट सीइंग एक्शन मूवी, ओके, यू सीइंग मोर बॉलीवुड मूवीज और हॉलीवुड मूवीज. इन हॉलीवुड मूवीज व्हाट इज द टाइप ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स ही इज वाचिंग, ही इज वाचिंग मोर स्टार वॉर्स मूवीज, इज वाचिंग मोर डीसी मूवीज, मार्वल मूवीज. बॉलीवुड में सलमान खान की मूवी ज्यादा देखता है कि बाकी की देखता है, अक्षय कुमार की देखता है. सो देन इट बिकम अ वास्ट नंबर ऑफ फील्ड्स व्हिच आर सम टाइम अननोटिस्ड. सो दैट डेटा साइंस पाइपलाइन, वी कॉल, आई कीप कॉलिंग एज अ पाइपलाइन. सो दैट पाइपलाइन विल हैव द फीडबैक एंड इट विल एनालाइज इटसेल्फ. देयर इज न्यू फीचर्स कमिंग और देयर एग्जिस्टिंग फीचर, देयर मे बी थाउजेंड्स ऑफ फीचर्स. वंस यू टॉक एक्चुअल डेटा इन रियल वर्ल्ड, देयर विल बी tremendous amount of features. When I say the feature means one consider is like, you all know databases, so feature is ek column, maan lo database ka ek column based database hai hamare paas, to uska ek column maan lo ek feature hai, aur wo feature hazaron lakhon ki sankhya mein hote hain, aur kai baar your data is not structured. Theek hai, acha, structured data aur unstructured data mein farak pata hai kisko kisko pata hai, to kisko स्ट्रक्चर और अनस्ट्रक्चर डेटा में फर्क पता है? Can somebody paste in the chat or like say okay I know that, or you can say okay I know that. किसी को नहीं पता?
सर, स्ट्रक्चर डाटा इज अ हाईली ऑर्गेनाइज्ड काइंड ऑफ डाटा. And while unstructured data is it does not have a predefined format, like it's not in a proper sequence or in a proper format.
Right, correct. Yeah, so you're right. So if I say precisely, the structured data always have all the features in all the rows of the data. Unstructured data, it might have all the rows in all the columns which belongs to all the columns, and it might not have, it may be have new column where you have empty fields or you not at all have that column. So for example, aapke SQL jo RDBMS hai jisko aap jo asset property follow karte hain, agar hum simple bhasha mein baat kare ki jo data aap Oracle mein store kar sakte ho, uske RDBMS system pe ya Microsoft SQL ke RDBMS system mein store kar sakte ho, jo ki asset property follow karta hai, right? The database ki asset property रिलेशन है, स्ट्रॉन्ग रिलेशनशिप. और जो डेटा में स्ट्रॉन्ग रिलेशनशिप नहीं है, जो बेस प्रॉपर्टी फॉलो करता है, जो कि आपका वो हमारा नॉन स्ट्रक्चर्ड डेटाबेस, इसको कि हम फ्लैट फाइल में डाल सकते हैं, कभी कदर हम उसको मोंगो डीबी टाइप के डेटाबेस में डाल सकते हैं, डायमंड, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ डेटाबेस अवेलेबल, डायमंड डीबी, मोंगो डीबी, सो उसमें रख सकते हैं ना। जेसन डेटा एक हो गया आपका, जेसन आपके पास एक जेसन का, जेसन, यू नो ऑल जेसन राइट, एग्जाम्पल होती है वैसे आजकल तो नोड जेसन, इट्स लाइक यू हैव अ टैग एंड यू हैव अ डेटा। अनदर एग्जाम्पल लाइक रिकमेंडेशंस, बाइंग रिकमेंडेशंस, योर फेस रिकग्निशन, बिकॉज कंसिडर लाइक रिकग्नाइजिंग योर फेस और ड्राइविंग अ सेल्फ ड्राइविंग कार, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ट्रेमेंडस अमाउंट ऑफ features, tremendous amount of rows or columns of data where you cannot predict what type of data will come. And those type of recommendation, those type of analysis or those type of product typically handled by data science. My audio is not clear? Hello? Is it clear now?
Yeah.
I think Divya, maybe it's problem at your end then. Okay. So now we come to the conclusion. There are two objectives on data science: to use the data products and decision science products. So for example, you have data products which are improve the performance by automatic making decision. So again, like you can predict on data, for example your searches based upon your forecasting, and it make the system automatic. You don't need a human intervention who can come and see, okay, what is output and what I should put as a feedback. I can take it automatically. So any data product you can still convert to a data science product while applying data science pipeline. So let's go to the what data scientists do. So they acquire the data, means if you want to do the analysis, you should know what is the source of the data. I'll say, like, if you want to right now we have a lot of problem with the COVID-19, and you want to analyze the how many people are posting that feeds in Twitter or social media just talking about COVID-19, what are the features, what they are talking about. So that means you know where to acquire the data, and that is a very important data science. As a data scientist, if you want, you should know if you need this type of data, what is the source where I can get and acquire the data. The second phase is cleaning the data, and trust me, it takes 80% of the whole time to clean the data. When the data come in petabytes, it's horrible to see that, to clean that data, and you need to, and you never know which part of data have a problem. So for example, you took a test, so there's a method, some method we follow, we as say it is a science. So start your experiment with some subset of your data. So that data might be very clean, but if once you go to the actual production environment, it's like many things come south to you, means it's very not predictable. So that's like typically take 80% of time. Once you clean the data and you normalize the data, you clear the noise from the data, and you have good entropy value, you have like less entropy value on the data, you can, another phase, you can go for explore the data. When I say the explore the data, you need to decide. So for example, data coming with thousands of features. So there is a techniques which data scientists use. They come to know which are data is useful. So that means the data is not very, fields which are not very correlated. When I say they're correlated, they should not have a very strong relationship with each other. They should be disjoint. Those features are good. क्योंकि हमको हर एक का फील्ड रखना है, हर एक टाइप के डेटा को लेना है अपने पास, तो वो फीचर जितना डिसजॉइंट होगा उतना यूजफुल होगा, और जितना फीचर एक दूसरे से मिलता जुलता होगा वो काम का नहीं है। उसको लेने का फायदा नहीं, क्योंकि वो हमेशा बोलेगा कि मैं पॉजिटिव, उसकी प्रोबेबिलिटी या तो 1 होगी या 0 होगी, तो वो इतना इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है डेटा. नाउ यू वंस यू गेट द डेटा यू क्रिएट अ मॉडल. मॉडल क्रिएट करना बड़ा काम है, देन यू नीड टू डिसाइड व्हिच व्हाट इज दिस प्रॉब्लम विल सॉल्व बाय व्हिच टाइप ऑफ डेटा एल्गोरिथम. I will show you like different. I will go like in the end different with different type of algorithm, different type of classes of algorithm which typically use on data science. Okay, we'll go in the end. And then you make that model useful, because making a model, anybody can make the model, but whether the model is useful, model cannot be. It should not be a very you can say deterministic. Cannot give like in one go, you give like value as a, if you talk about the terms of probability, you should not give like always 1. It should be like between the good model start with always between 0.5 to 0.7 values, right? And it should not be like coming as like always coming as 0. So those things we need to take care, and we come to know what type of model, if my model is actually relevant or not. Any question in this slide? This is very important to understand how what data scientist will do in day to day. So any questions on this slide? Mere question nahi puch rahe koi. When I was in my engineering, my teacher used to say me, don't ask me questions, you ask enough today. Okay, we'll move.
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yeah, Anjali.
Sir, we are exploring the data after cleaning the data. And as you know, cleaning of data takes lots of time.
I didn't get. Can you type? Still, your audio a little bit blurred. I not able to get. Can you type your question?
Now, can you? Yes, sir. Sure, sir. Sure.
Or you can repeat right at your question now. Yeah.
Sir, we are exploring the data after cleaning of data, as you told us, and some of the data is correlated, very correlated.
Mm-hmm.
We need to eliminate those data.
Okay, that's
why we are cleaning. Why we are cleaning the data if they are not required? Can we do that exploration part earlier of cleaning, so that the cleaning part, if it is not required, can be skipped for that particular data?
Okay. That's good. Very good question. So as a best practice, we'll not throw the data out. So you never know. For example, you do the cleaning and you delete that data, but you once you come back in the feedback, you might need the data. So what we do, we store the data, something we call something called dampening. It means we will not use the data in our exploration data phase, but we'll keep the data. So we drop the data, but we not delete the data.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And why we are doing so? Maybe you go back and you find, okay, I need this data, and it's like it's a hard part to clean the data and acquire the data. So you always keep that. Maybe you are not using that. So you just ignore the data.
Okay, sir. Right. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Now this is something we call the previous slide. It translate in actual when you work actually, when you like practical environment work, translate what is that? So data ingestion means how you ingest the data. On storage, when I say the storage, means you are storing the data on database, you are storing the data in flat file, you are storing the data on big data systems like Hadoop, SDFS, anywhere. So that is important, and that is and there's a whole field of skill set called data ops teams. They have storing the data. You might heard about the data lakes, Parquet files we put in a data lake and object storage. Not simply with the people who are actually responsible for maintaining that data in large scale. And we put that data in some system. Another second part is like cleaning the data, means wrangling the data. That took maximum time, 80% of time. Then like computation and analysis, that is exploration phase. Then modeling and application, that's a modeling phase. You model that and you test that, and the last time you report and visualize. So the data you need to be visualized, you use some visualization tools, Elopricks. There are a lot of tools available for doing that. There are a lot of open source tools. So I put all in the resource field, then you can go and explore that. So typically there are a lot of open source field, tools on that. Okay, this is a point where we do the feedback. So for each phase, to each phase we can go for feedback. Before, for example, and when I reach to my modeling and application, it's an iterative loop, it's a feedback based loop. And that can be automated or it can be run independently. So this is like actual working scenario. This is like operations run. So operations means your business as usual, ongoing, how you do. So you implement one product and now how you maintain that. So it's always required a new field to be added. I think somebody else start present. Are you able to see my screen or it's gone? Hello?
It's gone, sir. It is gone. I'm asking Love to stop sharing his screen. I guess he has mistakenly started sharing his screen.
Okay. Okay, it's visible now again. Hello?
No, sir. Yes, sir. Now it is visible.
Okay. Yeah. So this is simply talk about in general in production environment in real world. This is how the iterative loop works with the feedback. That's what I explained before. It's just like how it's work in actual scenarios. So now coming to the question, what skills I need, what resources I need. So how many people know the Pokemon? So I just it's like you know. So they see this elephant is called Hadoop. It's a symbol of Hadoop. So how many of you know Hadoop? So Hadoop is big data. It's a product which actually used for storing a large set of data. People keep calling about big data. So it has an algorithms called MapReduce, okay, and you have sharding mechanism, sharding the data. So consider like it's a system which can store and manage a big set of data in distributed manner. So it's like a distributed system where you store your data. Right, and the data is resilient, the data is fast to retrieve, fast read writes. Okay, let's leave it. Okay, so when the data science start with SAS, and SAS, the statistical team comes with a language called R. Where is R in my diagram? It should be here, yeah. This, if you see, this is pink color, it's R. So if you see in 2010, the R is like pretty much dominating the market, and gradually the Python start picking up, and there's a lot of development happened in the Python community which are related to data science. So there are a lot of libraries wrote for data science like Pandas, NumPy, so that is data science toolkit. So there are a lot of resources that Python developer contributed, even the data science team, a lot of people contributed towards the Python. And today is Python is more dominating in data science field. So the guys who are know Python, it's good. Even if you do in the R, that's okay. But my recommendation, what I see in the industry, the trend is to be moving more towards the Python. resources. So I put some resources. If you want to read, I put the books details. If you are interested, so now you need to decide where you want to start. You want to be a coding side first, you want to be a data modeler, you want to be a mathematician side, that side. So you can, so this is how you, there is a book called How You Analyze Your Data. If you beginner in Python, I will recommend, think Python is great resource for that. And if you already know Python enough in hacker level, you can go for a book called Python, your Python for data analysis. There's more books on machine learning. If you're interested on machine learning aspects, those books are available. So I will send those slides. The another thing I want to show you, we are already top of the hour. I quickly want to show you guys. It's two more resources. So for example, you start doing data science exploration. These are the, there is a lot of data sets which are available free of cost. The DUIC project, machine learning repository, you can have a lot of example data sets you can download from there. Here another is it's more famous in US is data gov, GOV, and you can get the data from data sets from different type of fields, and you can download that data and practice your data science skills. The another thing I just want to go quickly, it's like different, I was talking about the machine learning techniques, and these are typically, once you start, once you go to the modeling phase, you classify what type of algorithm you want to use. So you need to decide. So there's typically two broad category on machine learning. One is called supervised learning and another is called unsupervised learning. Supervised learning means you as a data exploration phase, you decide what are the features you want to use. That is called supervised learning. And two major classes is regression and classification. So if data might be a you want to classify your data, for example, you want to choose a books which people are going to read, and you can classify based upon their previous book read, their country, a lot of features you can classify. Another is called a regression type of problems. For example, you are predicting the mortgage rate or your loan rate to be in next 5 years, or how many people can be a defaulter in a loan. You can go for a regression. Another field come for your you can say non-supervised learning. It's mostly like people use the clustering, k-means algorithms. I will share that base too, but this you come to in this phase before when you understand, you start running your models and you start consuming the data, then you can come and start exploring the different techniques of data science. Any more questions? Okay, so we are top of the hour. So I will stop presenting here. I'm ready to take any questions if you guys have. Koi question nahi. Session bekar tha ekdam. Koi bhi question nahi hai.
Session was good, sir.
Okay. If
anybody has any questions, they can ask any questions. Question from Nikhil Sharma. He's asking, what is the difference between analysis and model phase, modeling phase in data science?
Okay. So analysis phase mein hum kya karte hain? Modeling se pehle hum field decide karte hain. कि हमें क्या क्या फील्ड पे मॉडल बनाना है. सो मेरे पास अगर 1 लाख 10,000-8,000 फील्ड्स हैं, फीचर, कीवर्ड फीचर, तो उसमें से मुझे कौन से फील्ड यूज करने हैं और उसकी टेक्निक्स हैं. सो मे बी अपकमिंग स्लाइड्स विल गो डीपर ऑन दैट. इट्स लाइक इंट्रोडक्शन. देयर आर सम एल्गोरिथम्स अवेलेबल टू डिसाइड, एज मैंने बोला, कौन सा डेटा बहुत ज्यादा कोरिलेटेड है, कौन सा डेटा कम कोरिलेटेड है, कौन सा डेटा मुझे ज्यादा सेंट्रिक दिख रहा है. तो वो हम एनालिसिस फील्ड में करते हैं. जब हम एनालिसिस कर लेते हैं, अभी मुझे पता चल गया कि यार ठीक है, ये डेटा सेट है, मुझे ये 50 फील्ड यूज करनी है, देन वी पुट इन द मॉडल. सो मॉडलिंग फेज में जो मैंने एल्गोरिथम बताई है आपको, वी क्रिएट अ डेटा सेट, वी क्रिएट अ डेटा मॉडल. डेटा मॉडल इज कि क्या क्या फील्ड यूज करेंगे, उसका ओरिएंटेशन क्या होगा, कितनी वैल्यूज होंगी और कौन से एल्गोरिथम हम लगाएंगे, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ मॉडलिंग फेज. आई होप आई विल एबल टू आंसर योर क्वेश्चन. Nikhil, am I able to answer your question?
Yes, sir. Sir, I have one more doubt. That then what we do in data extraction field, like we use the field, image field, and so on.
Data extraction. तो मैंने तुम्हें दो पाइपलाइन दिखाई थी. सो डेटा एक्सट्रैक्शन अगर वो वही फेज है जब कि हम डेटा एनालिसिस में यूज करते रहे, डेटा एक्सट्रैक्ट करा कि जो मेरे पास डेटा था उसको क्लीन किया, जो मेरी डेटा क्लीनिंग फेज थी. राइट, सो व्हेन वी क्लीन द डेटा एंड वी गेट द डेटा. सो क्लीनिंग का मतलब क्या है? क्लीनिंग का मतलब ये है कि तुम्हारे डेटा में बहुत सारी नॉइज हो सकती है, बहुत सारा डेटा नल हो सकता है. सो यू हैव लॉट ऑफ रोज, योर डेटा इज माइट बी अ नल. सो देयर इज अ टेक्निक कॉल्ड स्मोक टेस्ट, यू कैन रिमूव दोस डेटा. एक टर्म है एंट्रोपी कि तुम्हारे पास ऐसा डेटा है, बहुत अपसर्ड डेटा है, बहुत सारी रोज ऐसी है. राइट, तो वो फीचर्स हो गए कॉलम. अब बहुत सारी तुम्हारे पास ऐसी रोज हो सकती है जो काम की नहीं है, तो वो तुम हटाते हो डेटा से, दैट्स कॉल्ड डेटा क्लीनिंग. एंड यू जस्ट थ्रो दैट, यू जस्ट कीप द डेटा आउट ऑफ योर फेज वेयर यू कैन डिसाइड द फीचर्स. ठीक है, उसको थोड़ा क्लीन करेंगे नॉइज एट टाइम.
ओके,
और दूसरी इम्पोर्टेंट, the very important thing, I when I go through the interviews on big company, they want to listen your true story. So you should be honest, right? So अगर तुमने जो भी काम किया है, और ये बुरी बात नहीं है अगर कोई चीज आपको नहीं पता है. So you can say like I don't know, rather than giving the wrong answer. So जो भी करो अगर उसमें expertise है, उस चीज के लिए apply करते हो, तो why not? They are looking for people, right? So it's like you are the asset for those companies, not something like you are not. You are the boss once you're giving the interview. So if you are good, they will take you. I mean, they are behind you. Or any question? I think sir, हम close कर सकते हैं session, और काफी अच्छा लगा. I will have to run more
session. One minute, Manish, wait.
Okay.
Amit,
yes sir.
Any other question?
No sir. I have done all my activities. It's been short. All these things.
Okay, Manish, thank you very much.
Thank you. I think
there is some question.
We have one more question from the.
One more question is there.
So SaaS is not open source. It's like a paid software. But whatever you can do in SaaS, you can do in Python, something called scikit-learn. So अभी बस ये फर्क है कि SaaS में चीजें बनी बनाई हैं, तो like it's a licensed, it's a company, it's a commercial company. तो ये free नहीं है. You can try, there is some free tier for SaaS, but I will recommend go for scikit-learn when we start doing that. SaaS is like, it's another tool, but it's not technique, it's a tool which we could use for doing the data center tool.
Atul sir, can we request again to live all the students with the webcam right now, please?
All students, please open your webcam.
Fir se question padta. So career path ki height you need to decide, right? Ki tumhe kya height, what is your goal, tumhe kahan pahunchna hai. So there is uske koi ant nahi hai, log lifelong karte hain, right? So thing is that learning is continuous. So if you are skillful, you achieve lot of things. So what I'll suggest, you need to learn a lot, and sometimes you unlearn a lot. So learning is a continuous process.
तो टेक्नोलॉजी है, हम आईटी फील्ड में है जो कि बहुत वॉलेटाइल है, टेक्नोलॉजी रोज चेंज होती है. सो व्हेन आई स्टार्ट माय करियर एंड वर्सेस व्हाट आई एम टुडे, आई सॉ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज लाइक एचपी, आईबीएम, दे आर लाइक ऑन द बॉटम. अमेज़न जैसी कंपनियां हैं, माइक्रोसॉफ्ट है, गूगल है, दे आर लाइक ऑन द टॉप. गूगल हो गई, काफी और कंपनियां. तो टेक्नोलॉजी चेंज होती है, लोग जो जो अडॉप्ट करता है उस चेंज को वो आगे बढ़ता है. And then you need to decide what you want to do. Okay. So, आप तो वैसे स्मार्ट लग रहे हैं आज.
सही है.
Thanks, Rahul. और अतुल सर के पास बहुत सारे फंडे हैं, मतलब हम लोग पढ़ने आते थे सर के पास, तो सर ने बहुत सारी चीजें बताई. मतलब हम लोग कॉलेज के सबसे तेज स्टूडेंट थे. जो हमारा बैच के कुछ चार पांच लड़के थे, अनुराग दो चार थे, नाउ दे आर इन गुड प्लेस, दे आर लाइक इन सिस्को एंड रवि सर,
रवि केसरी, मनीष, जस्ट शेयर योर लिंक.
हाँ सर, मैं आपको भेज देता हूँ लिंक. मेरा मतलब मनीष पांडे वन है आखिरी में. ओके, लेट एक मिनट देना.